Hello and welcome to cookingflavors.com. Our channel is aimed at teaching beginners the ABCs of Indian cooking. We bring to you the very basic, simple, easy to learn and cook recipes and a guide to the most essential cooking strategies. Keep watching and enjoy our recipes. For today's video, we look at the preparation of homemade paneer as part of our how-to series. For that purpose, I've taken about 1 liter of milk here and I've put it on a pan to bring it to a boil. You can adjust the quantity of milk according to the quantity of paneer you require. Now, 1 liter of milk will roughly give me about 15 small cubes of paneer. Usually, for the best quality paneer, you need to take a combination of milk and cream, but just because most of our houses don't have cream handy, I'm only using milk. So to get best quality paneer with just milk itself, you need to take a milk which has a higher percentage of fat or which is also known as whole milk. If you take very thin milk, your quality of the paneer will not be very good. So I've taken a whole milk and I'm bringing it to a boil. We have to boil it. This is raw milk. I am bringing it to a boil. You have to boil it like you would boil your normal milk for preparation of coffee or tea. Now we'll wait for that to come to our nice boil. While the milk is coming to a boil, we'll get 2 ingredients ready. I have taken lemon juice from 2 big size lemons. You may not need the entire lemon juice, but keep it handy because last minute you can't keep hunting for lemons and cutting it and squeezing it. This is about 8 to 10 cubes of ice. Now the milk has come to a nice boil. You can see it's all frothing up. I'll slightly stir this a little. Now I've completely brought the temperature of my gas to low. Now it's time for us to add the lemon juice. While adding the lemon juice, add a little at a time. Now I'm stirring that continuously till I see that the whey separates from the protein. The whey is nothing but the clear water that you will see after the milk starts curdling, and the protein is the curdled milk when the milk starts to thicken. That is called the protein. So we'll stir it. It requires some more lemon juice. I'm adding some more here. We'll stir it again. Don't add all the lemon juice at a stretch. You have to add it little by little. Now I'm stirring it, you can see. Now you can see the whey water, that the clear water is called the whey water. And I'm adding just a little more. See, it required that much of lemon juice. So that's why I told you, keep a lot of lemon juice handy, because last minute when you're doing this process, you can't stop it and then go fish for some more lemon juice. So when it's handy, you can keep adding little by little. Now you can see the whey water is completely clear and the milk has curdled up nicely and it has come to one side. Now I'm adding some ice cubes here. The purpose why I'm adding the ice cubes here is I completely want to bring the temperature of the milk down. I've switched off the stove here and I'm bringing down the temperature of the milk. This ensures that you get very nice and soft paneer. If you don't add ice cubes, your paneer will become very tough like the store-bought paneer. So this will ensure to give you very soft paneer. I've taken a colander like this. You can take any vessel which has holes in it to drain out all the whey water. And I've lined it with a cheesecloth or a muslin cloth. Make sure you wet the cloth so that when you pour in the mixture, the cloth doesn't keep moving in here and there. Now we'll slowly pour in the mixture. Be careful, it's steaming hot. Be careful not to burn your hands. I've transferred the entire mixture into the colander. Now I'm turning in cold running water. The purpose why I'm using cold water here is, one, I want to bring down the temperature completely, and two, any sourness from the lemon will be left over there. So I want to completely take away the sourness of the lemon. So I'm completely washing it. Now we'll slowly pick it up and we have to squeeze down all the water. It's not hot because I've used cold water here, but be careful, ensure it's not hot and then squeeze it so that you don't burn your hands. So I'm squeezing it down completely. Don't worry, you may not be able to squeeze down all the water completely, when we put the weight, the excess water will come out. I've taken a large plate like this. It's large enough to hold my colander. I'm inverting my colander here today. You can take any plate or any vessel which has holes in it, because we still want to drip out all the excess water from the paneer, and the collected water will settle on the plate and doesn't mess up your counter. Now you can see the paneer looks very crumbly and it still has a lot of water in it. So we need to flatten this paneer and get out all the excess water out of it. Now the paneer that I will get will be of a round shape, because the colander on which I have placed it is circular in shape. So you can take any vessel of your choice. Now I'm slightly pressing it down and I'll be folding the cloth. Now I'm placing a plate on it so that it evenly flattens out. And I'm placing my mortar and pestle here. You should take something which is nice and heavy. This is the heaviest equipment that I have, and it's heavy enough to get my paneer ready. So I'm putting it on the plate and pressing it down. And I'm slowly moving the mortar and pestle across my plate so that it evens out the paneer a little. And I'm giving it a nice press. Now we'll leave this setup undisturbed for a minimum of 3 hours and we'll come back. After 3 hours, our paneer is done. You can see I got a big slab, a nice slab or a block of paneer. If you look, the edges look a little crumbly because the weight was not evenly distributed around the edges. And if you see, the center is nice and even because the concentration of the weight was in the center. You can store this paneer as it is like a slab in the refrigerator and cut it when you want to use it. But now I'll just cut it into cubes and show you how soft and nice our paneer is. Now I'll just show you one cube of paneer. See, we got a nice cube of paneer which is nice and soft. At the same time, it'll crumble well. Don't worry that it looks a little crumbly. If you put it in the refrigerator for one day, you will get the perfect consistency of the paneer. Now our homemade paneer is ready in a very simple and easy manner. Do post in your comments and suggestions and hit the like button. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and visit us at cookingflavors.com. You can also follow us on Google+. Thank you and see you again with another new and interesting recipe.